with me. Be on TV with me.
Good morning, Greenview.
It's February 8th.
Please stand for the pledge.
I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Seniors, all Greenview scholarships are due next Wednesday, February 14th by 2:30 p.m. No late applications will be accepted. Spring Fling. The Snow Bowl has been rescheduled for Friday, March 8th and renamed the Spring Fling. This is a formal dance. Dance contracts are available in the front office. If you have a dance contract from homecoming, you do not need to complete a new form, but any guests attending the dance must have a new guest contract on file. Carnations and Candygrams. The yearbook staff is selling carnations and candygrams next week for Valentine's Day. Carnations are $2 and candygrams are $1. Both can be purchased before school or in the cafeteria during lunch beginning on Monday. Support the yearbook and share a little treat with someone special. Lunch today, toasted cheese sandwich and tomato soup. Thursday sports. At 6 p.m., boys varsity wrestling versus Madeira. 4 p.m., varsity bowling at Fairfield Leesburg at 4. Girls JV basketball versus Dayton Christian, and 7:30 p.m. girls varsity basketball versus Dayton Christian. Make it a great day, Greenview.
Hey, Greenview, Mr. K here. Today, I want to introduce a new series that we're doing over the next couple of weeks called Their View. I gave the challenge to the digital communications students to create a video series where we interview lots of different kinds of people around Greenview, answering the question, what makes Greenview special? What makes Greenview their view? So you'll be hearing from some of your classmates, teachers, staff members, recent alumni, alumni from a long time ago, former teachers, all sorts of things are in store. We'll be showing some of those videos today, right now, during our special Thursday bonus episode of Greenviews, but also during the week, we'll show shorter clips of those videos. So be on the lookout. Maybe you too could be on their views.
I'll be the one to show you the way. You'll be the one to always complain. Be in the morning, come a bang, bang, bang. All out of then, I just can't wait. Cancel the thing that I said I'd do. I don't feel comfortable talking to you. That shit got to zip up, fixed on my shoe. Then I'll be in the lobby drinking for two.
So I'm Flory, I'm from France, and I'm a junior. I like it so much. I have meet really good people, and yes, I spend really good time here. There's like so much differences. For example, we eat dinner at 8 in the evening. So here when I eat dinner at 5, I'm like, oh my gosh, this is so early. There's like transportation. I use the bus a lot for grad school, like public transportation. The food is different, people are different, the language, of course. And I don't know, there's so much things. It's called Notre Dame des Minimes, and it's a school in my city, which is pretty big, like maybe like 4 times Greenview. And yes, everyone is so nice to me. Like, everyone helped me to spend really good time and to discover new things. And yes, I have a really good English level, and I just wanted to see like your culture and how things works here, and like see a little bit like American dream. And yes, really improve my English because I want to have a job and be able to speak English in my job. Maybe like not be with my family because they are stayed in France, and I'm here like in a host family. So I was scared of how it's gonna happen with my host family, how I'm gonna like live without my parents, and maybe a little bit scared about my English because it was not really good. I play tennis, but I'm pretty bad. I did only 1 year. I do a lot of dance since I'm young. I love it. And I do ski on the winter. That's like my favorite sport. Yes, I think about doing track, but I never did some before, so I don't know how it's gonna be because I never did some. And I wanted to cheer, but I came so late, and so I was not able to come in the team. Bye.
Hi, I'm Brad, and welcome back to another video. Today, we're going to be playing Star Wars Jedi Fallen Order. For those of you who don't know, this is the Star Wars game that came out a couple years ago, and I've played it a few times, and I absolutely adore it. But today, I'm going to be playing it on Grandmaster, so we'll see what happens.
Run it, run it, run it, run it. I run, I roll, I blow, I blow, I glow. I run, I roll, I blow, I glow, I glow.
All right, you know the drill. Grandmaster, I will be a Jedi by the end of this. I will have the Force by the time I finish this video.
Not an easy maneuver.
The Cal will double your pay for this jet.
Wow, Cal. What's your score?
Worth it.
That couldn't hurt. Huh?
Okay.
All right. Let's go.
Get to work.
This game is actually so gorgeous. To just like look out at the view. Over there. Come on.
Where are you going?
What are you doing, dude? Oh, the light's turning on. This is getting kind of scary, I'm not gonna lie. Really? What am I supposed to do now?
Train has stopped.
Yeah. Something's going on.
Everybody up. Identification ready.
Probably just another contraband inspection.
Yeah, just another contraband inspection, what he said.
You all.
This is definitely not just a contraband inspection.
Oh, down, Shrek! Down!
That's not what I meant.
This is TK-8190.
You ready?
Repeat, did you say Jedi?
There we go. Ah, ah. First two enemies down. In God of War, that took me like 15 minutes. Let's do this. You want some? You want some? You want some? Oh.
Pretty weak for a Jedi.
Shut up, dude. Ow.
That's the Vault Seer mentioned. Whoever I'm supposed to find must be waiting there.
Well, let's go find him.
Hold on, BD1. I'm coming.
Dude, he's messing him up. My turn. Oh, I don't remember the controls. There we go. All right. There we go. Yeah, I knew that. Oh! That genuinely caught me off guard. I did not expect that.
Healing stem.
You're full of surprises.
Okay, I don't know if I can show that in school.
That's better. Thanks, little droid.
I'm sure it is, you addict.
Okay. That's where we need to go. I can feel it.
Yeah, that would make sense, considering it's the only thing in this barren wasteland. What is that? That's my call.
Sierra was right.
So I don't know if you just heard, but I had to pause the recording because my mom was yelling my name. So I walk out into my living room and I see my big scary pit bull. He's about 100 pounds, wearing butterfly wings. And I don't even know. This is not at all. I thought like dinner was ready or something. Not seeing my dog in butterfly wings. Is that?
What's that?
I don't know. I was wondering if it was that. I have two options. Is there a third? I have three options. What's over there? This is still one of my favorite features in the game. I think this is so cool.
That thing looks like it smells worse than Grease does.
I really want to know what's in that. Ooh! Oh, this is an actual boss. Okay. Can I just walk in and get the... Nope. Cannot. Let's do this. Oh! Okay. What are we thinking? Oh my lord. Do I try it? Or do I just cut this out of the video and act like it never happened and just go back to the ship?
It appears that Brad has run out of time to edit this video. What wacky shenanigans will Brad get up to with the rest of the gang next time? I guess we will have to wait and see. Till next time, peace out, my slime.
Hi, I'm Janet Newhart Airy, and this is my view. In 1984, I was a 4 years experienced teacher. I'd taught first grade in Springfield after graduating at Wittenberg University, and I got a job at Greenview to head up the gifted program. It was a new program, and my classroom was a trailer behind the old Central building.
That was it. That was my first classroom at Greenview. All those years in the trailer. Cozy little classroom. Hundreds and hundreds of children passed through those doors. It was a great classroom. I really didn't want to move into the building. I begged Art Reiber, who was superintendent then, please don't make me move in the building. He said, you got to move in the building.
Greenview was, it was a bigger district in some ways in the 80s and smaller in others. It was bigger in that we had the high school, which is now the elementary, and we had Central, which was grades 5 through 8, and then we had two buildings out in the country that were elementary buildings, and those were grades K-5. It wasn't as developed. There weren't a lot of new houses in Jamestown, and it was just really a simple country district, big in area, big in heart, but small as far as population and houses, and we didn't have a McDonald's then. We had a little restaurant uptown called Curly's, where we could order out lunch, and a place called the Pizza Pantry. I was at Greenview for 31 years, and I retired in 2015. I saw hundreds and hundreds of children. I met wonderful families. Greenview was just a really special place to be. I think it still is a special place to be. I think we still have that small town caring and that small town atmosphere, and teachers and staff who love children and want to do what's best for them. But being in the trailer, that was an interesting classroom. It was a long, narrow trailer, and we had control of our heat. We had air conditioning. We had carpeting. And I had one of those old cast iron bathtubs with feet that I filled full of pillows. And there was a sign that said, rub-a-dub-dub, come read it a tub. And it was just the best classroom because it was like being in a little home. But then I had to go in a building, and then I had to be a little quieter, and I didn't have air condition. Room 124, when this was the middle school, and this was my classroom for 6 years, 18 in the trailer, 2 inside central, 6 in this room, and then I was in the closet room down the hallway for 2 years, but you can't see that because it has no windows. So this was my classroom for 6 years. And then when the new middle school opened, I had a huge big classroom there for the last 3 years of my career. So that's the way it is with any area of when you're an intervention specialist of any kind, you usually get the smaller rooms. So that was a really big pleasure my last 3 years to have a huge classroom and have air conditioning again. And I had to drive to work, though. Before, the buildings were across the street from me, and my cars would last forever because I would just walk to work every day. So my last 3 years were in the new building. And I know since I retired 9 years ago, there have been lots of changes in the district, and this year is kind of an end of a chapter year for me because the students that I had in my last third grade class are graduating. So after this year, there won't be any students in the school that I was their teacher. There are a lot of staff members that work at the school that I was their teacher back in the 80s and the 90s. And then some of them I even taught their children. So that's mostly my story. I could tell you a million other stories about my 31 years at Greenview, but the view from Greenview is a good view. People here have big hearts and they care. They work for the children. Families are involved in the schools. It's a good place to learn. It's a good place to teach. And I'm grateful that I was able to have 31 years in this community helping everybody raise their children. So it was a good thing. But this is the end of my teaching chapter this year with graduation. My last class moves on out into the world. Thank you.